reading climate is what it's all about. It is going to involve getting the entire community engaged.
November's Keep Louisville Safe initiative is focusing on campus safety. Jefferson County Public Schools, along with 13 local colleges and universities, are joining forces to ensure the security of students and staff.
We think that the Campus Watch program will be a valuable addition, and we feel like it will be a great program for building relationships with the community and for making our schools and our campuses safer.
LMPD will provide safety seminars and security surveys. Students will also be able to use the Citizen Observer website to learn more about crime trends and prevention tips.
We will, in fact, warn our partners in the school system of crime trends, crime that is occurring not only just in their particular neighborhood, but around their particular neighborhood, crime prevention tips, and any criminal activity that we think is germane to the safety of the students.
The Campus Watch program really is an innovative program for the city and for the police department, because for the first time there is this official collaboration between our department, every Jefferson County Public School, and 13 local colleges and universities.
Yeah, we want to be proactive. You know, difficulties have occurred in schools and in colleges across the United States over the last year or so. And we don't, if God forbid those difficulties happen here, we want to make sure we're prepared. So in doing so, we've reached out to the universities and the colleges, to the community college, and to the public schools throughout this community and said, hey, let's engage in assessing your facilities, make sure we have a layout of the school facility itself, make sure we're walking around looking at hedges and tree lines to be sure that they're trimmed properly for safety purposes, especially on the campuses. Those are the kinds of things that we want to work collaboratively with the education folks and working with the kids. We're also working on giving the young people in the schools an opportunity not only to call 574-LMPD if they in fact know something's going on or are concerned about something is going on, but they can now get on their mechanics, the cell phones or Blackberries, mm-hmm. or whatever the kids are using, and we're gonna. They can today text message to the police department.
Which concern. Our kids are much better at doing.
Our
than
children
us.
Are much better. My 16-year-old, like all day long, is doing.
And they type so fast.
And they do so fast. But the bottom line is that we're going to try to take it. The technology is available, and we think in the next couple of weeks we'll even be able to allow the text messaging to be done anonymously, just like when you call 574-LMPD. Tell them about something you think the police ought to look into. You don't have to give your name. We'll take it. A person will be there and answer you. Same thing on the text messaging. Right now, if you do it today, we will, in fact, because of the system as it exists, know who texted us, who text messaged us. Mm-hmm. I guess that's the verb.
I guess.
But within the next 2 or 3 weeks, we'll have a situation where anybody can text message into the police department anonymously. And we're looking forward to that. Working with kids on the campus, in the colleges, at the community college, and in the public school system.
And really, I know the education side is very important. Also, our officers are going to be in the classrooms, guest lecturers, spreading the word about the 574 LMPD tip line, which has
right.
been tremendously successful.
And creating the relationship of trust between the guys and gals on the college campuses, the kids and students in the high schools, middle schools, and elementary schools, so that they feel comfortable and confident in terms of they'll know how to respond. If they think something's happening, they're not sure what's going on, but they think something's not right, they'll now have an opportunity to be able to connect with the police department.
And that program can really be tailored to each school or campus, problems they see going on
no
within
question.
The school.
And that's why we're working not only with the head of security for the school system, the public school system, but also the head of security of everything from the Baptist Seminary, Presbyterian Seminary, the University of Louisville, Bellarmine, Spalding, Sullivan, and it goes on and on and on.
Right. Well, it's a great program, and I know a lot of folks and a lot of parents feel better knowing that new program is out there.
We hope so.
Well, the city is ready for snow and ready to light up Louisville. We'll take a look when we come back.
We want our residents to know that we're ready, and when the winter comes, we are prepared. For the first time, our Public Works Department will implement a winter overnight shift. We've never had that in the past. That's a crew that will be on and available between 7 o'clock at night and 5:30 in the morning. By having these drivers already at work, they can start salting, plowing, and pre-treating as soon as we get the word